राहुल चंदेगरा फ्रॉम डिग्री इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस. टुडे वी लर्न सर्कुलर कन्वोल्यूशन ऑफ फूरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म एंड इट्स एग्जांपल. सो क्वेश्चन इज यूजिंग ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑब्टेन 5-point सर्कुलर कन्वोल्यूशन ऑफ टू डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल डिफाइन एज yn इक्वल टू 1.5 raised to n and n belongs to 0 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 2. yn equal to 2n minus 3 where the n belongs from 0 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 3. So does the circular convolution obtained is same to the that of linear convolution? So question is that. So now first we will obtain the sequence x of n and y of n by putting the value of n. So here x of n equal to 1.5 raised to n, 0 less than or equal to n less than or equal to 2. So we will put n equal to 0, 1 and 2. So the, for the n equal to 0, x of 0 equal to 1.5 raised to 0 equal to 1. For n equal to 1, x of 1 equal to 1.5 raised to 1, it means 1.5. For n equal to 2, x of 2 equal to 1.5 raised to 2, it means 2.25. Likewise, x of n equal to the all three value 1, 1.5 and 2.25. So now we will find the y of n. So y of n equal to 2n minus 3 and we have to put n value from starting from 0 to up to 3. So for n equal to 0, y of 0 equal to 0 minus 3, it means minus 3. For n equal to 1, y of 1, 2 minus 3 equal to minus 1. For n equal to 2, y of 2 equal to 4 minus 3, so it is 1. For n equal to 3, y of 3 equal to 6 minus 3 equal to 3. So y of n equal to minus 3, minus 1, 1 and 3. It is asked to calculate 5-point DFT. That means the length of each sequence should be 5. This length is as adjusted by adding 0 at the end of each sequence as follow. It's called a zero padding. So x of n equal to 1, 1.5, 2.25, 0 and 0. So we put two zeros. And y of n equal to minus 3, minus 1, 1 and 3 and 1, 0. So length of x of n and y of n should be 5. Now according to the definition of circular convolution, we have y of m equal to summation n equal to 0 to up to capital N minus 1 x1 of n multiply with the x2 m minus n and capital N. So here capital N equal to 5. So y of m equal to summation n equal to 0 to 4 x of n y m minus n suffix 5. So draw first in the circular method we have to draw x of n and y of n. So we draw x of n in the anti-clockwise direction. So whatever the value of x0, x1 and x2 and x3 in the anti-clock direction. So we put x of 0 equal to 1, x of 1 equal to 1.5, x of 2 equal to 2.25, x of 3 equal to 0 and x of 4 equal to 0. So this is x of n. Likewise y of n. So y of 0 is here, y of 1, y of 2, y of 3 and y of 4. Now we will obtain the value y of m by putting m equal to 0 to up to 4. In the equation, so when we put m equal to 0, so the y of m equal to 0, so y of 0, so it is summation n equal to 0 to 4 x of n y of minus n. Now we already plotted x of n and y of n. For y of minus n, it indicates the folding of y of n. It is obtained by plotting y of n in clockwise direction. So now we plot y of minus n, so it is y of 0, and the clockwise direction y of 1, y of 2, y of 3 and y of 4. Now according to the equation, y of 0 is obtained by adding all product term as shown in the next figure. So here we plot both. This is x of n and this is y of minus n. So we will multiply each term and add them. So it is x of 0, y of 0, then next term, then next term, then next term and then next term. So it is y of 0 equal to 1 multiply with the minus 3 plus 0 multiply with the minus 3 plus 0 multiply by 1 plus 2.25 multiply with the 3 plus 1.5 multiply with the 0. So it is 3 plus 0 plus 0 plus 6.75 plus 0. So y of 0 we get 3.75. Now we have to find y of m. So we just put m equal to 0. Now we put m equal to 1. So putting m equal to 1, so y of 1 equal to summation n equal to 0 to up to 4 x of n y 1 minus n. So now it is indicate the delay of y of minus n by one sample. So we already plotted y of n in anticlock direction, then y of minus n in clockwise direction, but here the delay is 1, so it is obtained by shifting y of minus n by one sample in anticlockwise direction. So here we plotted y of 1 minus n. So here is the y of 0, then the y of 1, y of 2, y of 3 and y of 4. Now we have to multiply x of n with the y of 1 minus n. So one by one we have to multiply these things and also this and add. So y of 1 equal to 1 multiply by minus 1, 0 multiply by 1, 0 multiply by 3, 0 multiply by 2.25, 1.5 multiply with the minus 3. So we will get y of 1 equal to minus 5.5. Now the m equal to 2. So we have to put m equal to 0 to 4. So we already did m equal to 0, m equal to 1. Now we have to put m equal to 2. So y of 2 equal to summation n equal to 0 to 4 x of n y of 2 minus n. So now again we have to shift y of minus n by 2 sample by the anticlockwise direction. So y of 0 will be here, y of 1, y of 2 and y of 3 and y of 4. So now we have to multiply this circle with the x of minus n. So just we have to follow our procedure in all the case. The procedure is the same. So here x of n, inside circle is x of n and outer circle is minus n 2, y of 2 minus n or minus n plus 2. So again for y of 1, y of 2, we have to multiply these things and add them all. So I have 2 equal to 1 multiply with the 1 plus 0 multiply with the 3 plus 0 multiply with the 0, 2.25 multiply with the minus 3, 1.5 multiply with the minus 1. So we will get after calculation y of 2 equal to 7.25. Likewise, y of 3 we have to shift in the anticlockwise direction by the 3 sample. So we will get y 3 minus n, and again we have to multiply with the x of n, and y of 3 we will get 2.25. Likewise, y of 4 we have to shift y of minus n by 4 sample in the anticlockwise direction, and then multiply with the x of n, we will get y of 4 equal to 6.75. So I just skip the calculation because already the same method, whatever we find in y of 0, y of 1 and y of 2, similar way we have to find y of 3 and y of 4. So now y of m equal to y of 0, y of 1, y of 2, y of 3 and y of 4, all the values. So y of m equal to 3.75 minus 5.5 minus 7.25 and 2.25 and 6.75. So we will get circular convolution. Now comparison with the linear convolution. So we have to obtain linear convolution. So here x of n equal to 1.5 2.25. So in linear convolution we have to match the length. So y of n have 4 sample but x of n have a 3 sample, so we will zero padding only 1 0, so the length will be same. So x of n become 1 1.5 2.25 and 0, and y of n equal to minus 3 minus 1 1 and 3, so it is both are the same length. Now for the linear convolution, y1 of n equal to x of n convolution y of n. So this way all the y of n, and upward side it is x of n. So multiply the first term, 1 multiply with the minus 3 minus 3, then minus 3 multiply with the 1.5, so it is 4.5. so I will take minus 3 and multiply with the all upper side, so minus 3 multiply with the 2.25 it is 6.75, minus 3 multiply with the 0 it is 0. Now the next term minus 1, so all the upper value will be minus, so it is minus 1 minus 1.5 minus 2.25 and 0. Now the next term is 1, so all upward side is the same, 1 1.5 2.25 and 0. Then the plus 3, so 1 multiply by 3 is 3, 3 multiply with the 1.5 it is 4.5, 3 multiply with the 2.25 it is 6.75 and 0. Now we have to give diagonal name, so it is y1 of 0, this is y1 of 1, this is y1 of 2, this is y1 of 3, this is y1 of 4, this is y1 of 5 and this is y1 of 6. So y1 of 0 it is minus 3, y1 of 1 is equal to minus 1 minus 4.5, so it is minus 5.5. y1 of 2 equal to 1 minus 1.5 minus 6.75, so it is 7.25. y1 of 3 it is 3 plus 1.5 minus 2.25, so it is 2.25. and y1 of 4 equal to 4.5 plus 2.25, so it is 6.75. likewise y1 of 5 equal to 6.75 and y1 of 6 equal to 0. So x of n convolution y of n, so we will get after the linear convolution इस वैल्यू इज माइनस थ्री माइनस 5.5 माइनस 7.25 2.25 एंड 6.75 6.75 एंड 0. सो इट इज द आंसर ऑफ वी हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ लीनियर कॉन्वोल्यूशन एंड दिस आंसर इज फ्रॉम द सर्कुलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन. सो बोथ आर नॉट सेम. सो सर्कुलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन एंड लीनियर कॉन्वोल्यूशन आर नॉट सेम. वी विल गेट डिफरेंट आंसर इन द डिफरेंट मेथड. सो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सर्कुलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स मेथड. सो वी हैव टू प्लॉट सो मेनी टाइम्स सर्कल एंड वी हैव टू शिफ्ट एंड सो मेनी थिंग्स वी हैव टू डू. सो इट इज टाइम कंज्यूमिंग मेथड. सो वेन एवर वी गेट सम प्रॉब्लम वी फाइंड सम सोल्यूशन. सो हियर द सोल्यूशन ऑफ टाइम कंज्यूमिंग एग्जाम्पल इज द सर्कुलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स मेथड. द ग्राफिकल मेथड विच वी हैव स्टडीड इज टेंडियस स्पेशली वेन मेनी सैम्पल आर प्रेजेंट वाइल द मैट्रिक्स मेथड इज मोर कन्वीनियंट. इन द मैट्रिक्स मेथड वन सिक्वेंस इज रिपीटेड वाय सर्क्यूलर शिफ्टिंग ऑफ सैम्पल. सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंट एज फॉलो वी हैव वाई ऑफ एम इक्वल टू एक्स ऑफ एन सर्क्यूलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन एच ऑफ एन. सो एच ऑफ एन सर्क्यूलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन एन मल्टीप्लाई विद द एक्स ऑफ एन. सो हियर सो ओनली वन थिंग्स वी हैव टू डू एंड वी विल गेट द सर्क्यूलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन. सो हियर y of m, so it is y of 0 to up to y of n minus 1. Next thing, very important things, so here h of 0, h of 1, h of 2 up to h of n minus 1. So whatever the last term we have to repeat here, so it is h of n minus 1, then the repeat other thing from here h of 0, h of 1, h of 2 up to h of n minus 2. Then again we have to repeat from here. So it is indirectly shifted by 1. So h of n minus 2, h of n minus 1, h of 0 up to h of n minus 3. So on we have to do up to we will get the h of 0 here. Now the next matrix is x of 0. So x of 0, x of 1 up to x of n minus 1. You will better understand after solving one example. So we will move to next example. Obtain the circular convolution. So then question will never ask which method you have to follow, direct circular convolution or matrix convolution. You can use whatever you know very well. So here x1 of n is 1 2 3 1, x2 of n is 4 3 2 2. So we have y of m equal to x2 of n circular convolution x1 of n. So here using matrix method, so we have value x1 of 0 equal to 11, x1 of 1 equal to 2, x here the x1 of 2, it is x1 of 2 equal to 3. So correction in that, x1 of 3 equal to 1, x2 of 0 equal to 4, x2 of 1 equal to 3, and x2 of 2 equal to 2, and x2 of 3 equal to 2. So in the matrix form we have y0 to y3, x2 here we put x1, so x1 of 0, x1 of 1, x1 of 2, and x1 of 3. After the convolution sign, it is x2. So we put here x2 of 0, x2 of 1, x2 of 2, and x2 of 3. Then the 3 will be repeat. Then x2 of 3, x2 of 0, x2 of 1, x2 of 2. Here the 2 will be here. So x2 of 2, x2 of 3, x2 of 0, and x2 of 1. Then x of 2 of 1, x2 of 3. And here we will get the same. Let me show you. X2 of 0 and the last term x2 of 0. So it will be must be match. So up to that point, so here 4, so here 4 column is there. So we'll get repeated. So y of 0, y of 1, y of 2 and y of 3, we have to find it. So here we put the value. So it is matrix. So we have to multiply 4 multiply with the 1 plus 2 multiply with the 1 plus 2 multiply with the 1 plus 3 multiply with the 1. So it is first. Then 3 multiply with the 1, 4 multiply with the 2, 3 multiply with the 2, 2 multiply with the 2. So on we have to do. So after calculating, we get 4 multiply by 1, 2 multiply with the 2, 2 multiply by 3 and 3. So we will get 4 plus 4 plus 6 plus 3. So it is 17. So here next, 3 multiply by 1, 4 multiply by 2, 2 multiply by 3 and 2 multiply. So it is, we will get 19. So same way we have to find, and we will get y of 0, y of 1, y of 2 and y of 3, like 17, 19, 22 and 19. So y of m equal to x2 of n circular convolution x1 of n equal to 17, 19, 22 and 19. So we already know that the circular convolution and linear convolution is not same. So there is the question, why the result of circular and linear convolution is not same. Basically, circular convolution y of m contains same number of sample as that of x of n and h of n. In previous example, x of n, h of n, in we defined it is a 4 sample. The circular convolution is given by equation 1. So the linear convolution, we add more zeros as per the n number of n point convolution. Here the number of sample are 15. So we will use the following notation to indicate the number of sample. So L equal to number of sample in x of n, m equal to number of sample in h of n, and n number of sample in the result of linear convolution. So for the linear convolution, we can write the equation n equal to L plus m minus 1. So for the this reason, we will get the not same result in linear and circular convolution. For the obtain the same result from the linear convolution and circular convolution, for the calculate the value of n, that means the number of sample contained in linear convolution, let us say it is 15. By doing zero padding, make the length of every sequence equal to 15. That means in the case we need a to 70 in x of n as well as h of n. Perform the circular convolution. The result of circular and linear convolution will be same. If we put the same length in the both the convolution, then we will get the same result. Otherwise, we will not get the same result. So directly switch to summary of properties. DFT property. So first is property, next time domain and frequency domain. So periodicity, x of n equal to x of n plus n equal to x of k equal to x of k plus n in frequency domain. Then the linearity, a1 x1 of n plus a2 x2 of n. So in DFT, it is a1 x1 of k plus a2 x2 of k. Time reversal, so in time domain, x of n minus n equal to, in the frequency domain, it is x of n minus k. So circular time shift, x of n minus l of n point, that is एक्स ऑफ के ई रेस टू माइनस जे टू पाई के एल अपॉन एन, सर्कुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी शिफ्ट. सो इट इज एक्स ऑफ एन ई रेस टू जे पाई टू एल एन अपॉन एन. सो इट इज एक्स ऑफ के माइनस एल ऑफ एन. सर्कुलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन x1 ऑफ n सर्कुलर कॉन्वोल्यूशन x2 ऑफ n इक्वल टू x1 ऑफ k मल्टीप्लाई विद x2 ऑफ k. सर्कुलर कोरिलेशन, सो x1 x ऑफ n सर्कुलर कोरिलेशन कॉन्वोल्यूशन y कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ माइनस n इन द टाइम डोमेन. सो इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन इट बिकम x ऑफ k multiply with the y conjugate of k. Multiplication of two sequence x1 of n multiply with the x2 of n. So it is in frequency domain or in DFT it is 1 by n x1 of k circular convolution x2 of k. Complex conjugate x complex conjugate of n in frequency domain it is x conjugate of capital N minus k. In Parseval's theorem it is in time domain it is summation n equal to 0 to up to capital N minus 1 x of n y conjugate of n. So it is 1 upon n summation k equal to 0 to up to n minus 1 x of k y conjugate of k. So from the next lecture we will switch to Laplace transform. Thank you.